Alex here from Connectify. IRL live streaming is a lot of fun, but it can be expensive to get the equipment necessary to keep a stable HD stream going while you're out and about. One of the most popular pieces of hardware for this, and it's on the low end of the potential budget range, is the $995 LiveU Solo, featured in the official $1,600 Gunrun IRL Streaming Backpack. Let's see if we can use new Speedify for Linux technology to assemble a similar working setup for a fraction of the price. Exciting title. For this IRL streaming setup, we're using the Raspberry Pi as the centerpiece. We want to stay pretty close to a standard IRL streaming setup on the outside, keeping cables as concealed in the backpack as possible. We also want to be able to use a standard HD video camera, so as to make it work with the Raspberry Pi, we're going to need a capture card capable of transcoding the raw camera footage into a format that the Pi can upload. Then, we'll need to program a button that can start and stop the stream. Finally, to keep the stream stable and reliable while moving around outside, we want to incorporate channel bonding so that we can send data out over multiple 4G connections from different carriers at the same time. And the plan is to keep the total budget as low as possible. Let's get started. What do you need?
What do you need?
We decide to go for the Sony AS300 for the camera, since it's a nice, portable, wide-angle HD camera and a popular choice for streamers. At $298, it will take up the biggest chunk of our budget. You should be able to swap it out for any other camera that works with a USB live capture card. We'll hook it up to the Pi with a micro HDMI cable plugged into an Elgato Cam Link capture card, adding $116. Next, we'll use a Raspberry Pi 4 for the computer for an additional $55. To keep it cool and protected in the backpack, we purchased a $10 Geek Pi acrylic with fan RPI 4 case. We'll also need a battery to power the whole setup, which we purchased for $38. To control the stream, we'll use a Circuit Playground Express as a remote, which we picked up for a total of $30, including the plastic case. We're holding everything together in a cocoon gridded accessory organizer we got for $11, and we decide to mount both the camera and the Circuit Playground remote on a $28 Smartree telescoping selfie stick. For the backpack, we're just using a JanSport backpack we already had laying around. Finally, we'll need our mobile connections. You can borrow some phones from friends to tether or plug in a few cellular adapters. Here, we'll be using a couple of phones plugged in via USB. This brings the total budget to about $600, which is still about $1,000 cheaper than the Gunrun backpack. And you may not need to purchase all of this equipment if you already have similar items available. To get everything working for IRL streaming, we installed Speedify and FFmpeg on the Pi. I'll link to more detailed instructions in the description below. We programmed buttons on the Circuit Playground Express to start and stop FFmpeg streaming with a Python script that runs this hefty command. This command lets us stream live to Twitch in 720p at 24 frames per second, which is about as good as the Pi can handle. We'll have our code set up the streaming buttons available in a link in the description below. Speedify is set to automatically start, so it runs as soon as the Pi boots up. This way we don't need a UI for the Pi once we get everything together. So let's test it out.
What time is it?
1:26.
Do you want to hold the backpack?
How long?
44 minutes.
All right. Hey, this is Alex from Connectify. So this is the first test, just streaming live of our new IRL Speedify streaming backpack. So we've got a Raspberry Pi, we've got two tethered cell phones, and we are just walking around the city of Philadelphia. So I guess we are 45 minutes in. I can't see it, but I'm hearing from people that it's been working well.
Yeah.
So we'll see. It looks like a successful test. So we'll be both, you know, uploading the video clips as well as the instructions on how we built this thing and how to use it. So let's go back to Connectify's office. I gotta get back to the lab. Thanks for watching. Be sure to give us a thumbs up and subscribe. Tap the bell for notifications so you can stay up to speed on all of our latest content.